the IPW heavyweight title. He's from all the way in the Northeast. Independent superstar, Don Montoya. He's a partner in crime of the guy you saw last week, Reckless Youth. And there's your champion with Tiffany, Agent Steel. Sands, I told you I was scrambling for a good replacement. I found a great one. My good buddy, Rock Steel.
Well, Ann Roy, it's my distinct pleasure to be in here with you. Commentating this fine matchup.
Oh, look at that legal tag by Don Montoya.
I don't think there's a tag match going on. I think this is for the IPW Heavyweight Championship. And speaking of IPW Heavyweight Championship, we got November 30th, Independent Armageddon at the Florida Expo Hall right here in Pinellas County, just a little north here of IPW's Florida WrestlePlex on US 19.
Rod Steele, you've learned well from Rod Neiman. You come in, first thing you do is plug one of our shows. Great job, pal.
Hey, I'm not afraid to shamelessly plug as our champ locks up with Don Montoya here, center of the ring, forcing him back now. Don Montoya may be a little heavy for our man Bruce, but I'll tell you what, another cheap shot by our... See, Agent Steele not afraid to throw a little cheap shot to our way by Don Montoya, eh?
No, he's not. Agent Steele, he's known to take any way he can to hold on to that IPW heavyweight title. The fans here love him. Referee Richie Rich loves him, but he's checking on Don Montoya, complaining about a busted lip, I think. He's seeing a close punch. Who cares, Don Montoya? This is IPW. If you can't hack it, head back to Puerto Rico, head back up north, but get the hell out of here, because this is where the tough men play.
Well, Aaron, I got to tell you, though, the rules clearly state you are not to use a closed fist.
Blah, blah, blah.
We are strictly for the rules around here. I remember Honest Eddie was coming out here with the IPW rule book, and Bruce... Agent Steele's not here for
you. I'll tell you what, you're a little flustered there having to take the place of Ron Neamey. I can understand it. Those are some small, small shoes to follow. Don Montoya again with the legal tag in the corner.
I don't think it was a legal tag. I'm just telling you. Poor Richie Rich is here, not sure what's going on.
Big hip toss on the big man by Agent Steele. Taking over Don Montoya, who misses both guys with a clothesline. Kicked right in his ample gut by Agent Steele. Oh,
oh
hey,
what is
Richie
going
Rich.
On here? Richie Rich is supposed to be an official, not in here throwing moves around. I don't care. This looks like blatant biasm by Richie Rich. Look at this. He's hip-tossing the opponent here. What kind of rules do we got going on here,
I swear, you are just channeling Ron Neamey, messing up the easiest of words. Don Montoya,
see, I can't blame Don Montoya. I can't blame him for leaving. If you're not going to call a fair match down the middle, Richie Rich, I wouldn't want to be in the same matchup with Agent Steele myself.
If those doors would open, if the guys doing the doors hadn't taken a bathroom break, Don Montoya might very well be out of here, but I don't see him get to the doors. They're giving the 10 count. I don't think he wants to lose the match this way, Rod.
No, absolutely not. You can't win the belt on a count out, so Don Montoya's got to get back in there and face our champ.
You already saw his buddy Reckless Youth. He had a great, great match here last week with Naftali, but was ultimately unsuccessful from taking that Florida Unified Cruiserweight title. And speaking of guys like you and Naftali, you'll both be a part of that match that I booked, Don Montoya holding his neck, that I must have been crazy for booking. It's going to be you and this man, Agent Steele, taking on Jarrell Clark and Naftali. But I've got a plan, and I've got a big, big surprise for all four of you on that show. That show's right here tomorrow night at the WrestlePlex.
Well, I got to tell you, me and Agent Steele hooking up, it's all that's going to cause is trouble down the line. Right now, he's our champion here at IPW, but anytime you hook up with Agent Steele, it's bound to be a big, fat whooping.
It's the Steele family against two cruiserweights, but right now, no cruiserweight Don Montoya getting manhandled by our champion, Agent Steele. He may be a guy that's a little goody-two-shoes despite the cheap shots here and again. I may not always give him his due, but Agent Steele, a fighting champion, a very successful champion. He's beaten guys like Scoot Andrews, Billy Fies, Mike Sullivan, Mike Shane, Pat McGroin, on down the line, and right now he's trying to add to that arsenal by beating the man from the Northeast, Don Montoya.
Well, see, those here now, Agent Steele's using a little leverage on the, obviously, Don Montoya, the bigger of the two. He's got
Hello,
to use the
Tiffany.
Speed. Yeah, that's actually a good shot. A good call on that.
And, you know,
sometimes.
Tiffany on a radio show that I was on at the Dallas Bowl Lounge, she was on the radio when I was, and this is a controversial statement. Maybe it'll come up tomorrow night. She said when she's done with Agent Steele, Rod Steele is next. I don't know what that means, but no matter what, you sound like a lucky, lucky man.
I am a lucky man. I got to tell you, she was on a radio program with me, but you really didn't hear much she had to say because it's not good. Well, this is a family show. I can't
this
really
is a
talk about
show. I
can't really
can't.
Say where I was going to go with that. Once again, back to Agent Steele, working the mighty thick arm of Don Montoya, sitting there dead center of the ring. You got to get some set in there, Agent. You got to get there tight, strong. Just kind of the kind of stutter step. Aaron, please help me out here. I'm dying out here.
You are dying out here. I thought I was getting a competent replacement for Ron Neamey, but don't take that the wrong way. We're still good pals, Rod.
Well, that's what I appreciate you out of, Aaron. You know, sometimes when a guy's a little floundering, a little in the middle of the ring, just like Agent Steele does, getting big clubbering shots by Don Montoya.
He's a clubbering.
He is a clubbering, just like Mr. T circa 1995 Rocky.
Mr. T wasn't even around in 1995. I mean, he'd been around, but he was way, way gone.
I don't think I'm really good at dropping the names like Ron Neme is. I'm really just trying to do the same thing everyone's used to around here. A couple big right shots there by Agent Steele, shoots him in, right back into the ropes. Boom, another arm drag. See, using that speed, using that leverage. Oh, man, I've been on the receiving end of a couple of them hits. They aren't the prettiest things in the world. Big spin up and
around. Don Montoya very, very lucky that he hasn't gotten the chop effect yet from Agent Steele. Everybody here in IPW can throw the chops, and Agent Steele among the best of them, but he's trying to slam the big man. And I don't know if Don Montoya didn't have enough taken out of him or if Agent Steele had too much taken from him already, but he couldn't get the big man up, and he takes a big forearm to the back. Don Montoya, your challenger, taking over this title match.
Some of the inexperience by our IPW heavyweight champion, Agent Steele, trying to slam the big man. That man's got to weigh 500, 600, 700 pounds in the middle of that ring. There's no way he's just going to be able to lift him up.
You do have Ron Neme going through your body, the king of the exaggeration, and you're taking up right where he left off. About the only thing you're missing that's always here when Ron Neme's here is the booster chair to reach the microphone.
Well, I don't need any booster chair to get up. As a matter of fact, speaking of getting up, you got to go to www.highspots.com. You can see this whole match in its entirety. You can see the Reckless Youth Naftali matchup. Tremendous matchups all around, and you can see them in their entirety if you go to www.highspots.com or even go through ipw-hardcore.com.
Exactly. And fans, if you want to train to be a wrestler, you want to come out here and be trained by guys like Agent Steele, my good friend Rod Steele, our cruiserweight champion Naftali.
Raking the eyes across the ropes. Don Montoya not afraid to bend the rules a little bit from Agent Steele's couple shots early in the match. I can't see why he wouldn't want to use a little kind of chicanery, not arguing with the ref. Not afraid to get in Richie's face either.
No, nobody seems to be afraid to get in Richie Rich's face until he hits him with that stunner. He's giving him a hip toss. If you don't watch out, Don, the stunner might be next.
Boy, if he gets the ample.
Big splash.
Uh-oh, down goes the champ, dead center of the ring, Montoya, showing the savvy, the ring presence that he has.
Oh. If he had so much ring presence, he would have tried to cover him right there. Instead, he's trying to look pretty, pointing to his head like he's...
There you go, the big girl, two. Almost a big three count here, Aaron. I don't mean to cut you off. I'm just getting excited to see my man, Agent Steele.
You didn't cut me off. Steele. Didn't cut me off at the same time. That's commonplace around here. And he throws Agent Steele out of the ring. But as I told his buddy, Reckless Youth, last week, you've got to hook the leg, Don Montoya. You've got to hook the leg.
Absolutely. We're not talking a lightweight. We're talking our IPW heavyweight champion. You got to hit every... Little cheap shot there by Don Montoya. But Tiffany, maybe the X Factor causing a little problems here for Agent Steele. See, you know, you can't always trust these women. They do.
Women always causing problems, whether it be in the bedroom or in the ring. Now Richie Rich, I think he saw the chair shot.
And another almost near fall here by Don Montoya.
That time you cut me off, Rod.
I don't know what came over me here. I'm trying to call a fantastic matchup here in the middle of the ring, and you're too busy marking out for Tiffany on the side there, who's too busy getting Agent Steele in a wee bit of trouble.
Yeah, but she is hot.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I guess she
What's he doing?
That.
Oh, big spinning leg drop right across the throat of our champion. And I think if he wasn't showboating one more time and went for the quick pinfall, here he goes. One, two. Did not hook the leg again. Richie Rich may be a little bit slow on that count. I've got to give
him up. Here she goes again, distracting the ref. Here goes Don Montoya, getting ready right underneath the gun. Richie, turn around, man. She's right there choking him out. Help me, dear God.
Are you rooting for Don Montoya or are you rooting for Agent Steele? You're flipping back and forth worse than Bill Clinton during his 8 years in office.
I don't know anything about that, but I do know this. She's still up there, and she's going to cause Agent Steele the match. I got to tell you, I don't like these women down on the sidelines. All they do is get in the way. They belong in one place, and that's the bedroom.
Or over at Extra Innings after all of our shows, where they come and mark out for guys like Aaron Royal and sometimes even guys like Rod Steele.
Sometimes my eye.
Oh, he's choking him again.
Oh, look at this.
Tiffany, what are you
doing? Tiffany, gotta get out of there, Toots. All you're doing is causing problems.
And what people don't know is before this match, there was an altercation, a verbal agreement. Not only was he putting the title on the line, Agent Steele, he was putting Tiffany on the line for a night as well. And now she seems to distract the ref to give Don Montoya the advantage. Is she looking for the big man? Loving. Hey, that's the question.
Well, you know, that wouldn't surprise me in the least. Look at her now turning right back to her man, Agent Steele. He's getting a little support from the crowd, powering his way up. The big man's got to use his weight on him now. Oh, a couple big stiff shots here. Ooh, shoots him.
Actually, after the second one, it was a couple. It was one when you called it.
Such a freaking pie hole.
But he's hitting him in the back with those forearms once again. And there he just throws the tape at Tiffany. She's acting like she doesn't want anything to do with him. A sure sign that she wants it, if you ask me.
That's the classic grade school, I hate you, so I'll punch you, but I really like your technique. Here we go, Don Montoya. Big slam, dead center of the ring. Good, look at him, just using all that size. I'll tell you what, for a big man, look at him.
No, he's not.
Nobody that size is going to be able to do comes on a flippy move
here.
I
thought he was going to the top rope. Oh, my God.
How did he get his big butt over? I'm amazed by this, Aaron.
I don't know, but you get your big butt over out there all the time. You can't get the fans to boo you as much as you'd like.
Bobby Rogers style.
Or sorry, Buddy Rogers, not Bobby Rogers. I get confused between one of the greatest wrestlers of all time.
See,
oh, there he's blowing kisses at Tiffany. She's blowing it off.
Baby.
Hey, we already know she has experience with the big man, as she was broken in by none other than the manager of champions, Mike/Mark/Marvin Gold.
Well, HR pumping stuff, Mark, what's his name again?
Something Gold, I don't know. I just called in the money, Mark.
Either way, look at this, climbing right to the top rope. We've already seen this man can fly, this man can flip. This could very well be spelling the end
but
of Agent Steel.
But taking too much time once again. Rod, you know, you've only been in the ring about 3 years now, but you know you just can't do that.
Absolutely not. You can't wait to get up.
And that's exactly why.
That's what's called paying the price. Big fist drop. Agent Steel looking a little hobbled there. What happened here?
Agent Steel kicked out here. Yeah, Agent Steel a little bit worse for wear, but he was able to at least try to go for that pinfall attempt. And his knee seems to be hurting him a little bit there, Rod Steele.
I think he might be right, Aaron.
I didn't see anything that happened, but he's holding on to his knee. All right. We don't normally stop matches because of injury here in IPW. Agent Steele is going to have to go on. He's going to have to defend that title on one wheel.
See, that's the whole thing about being a champion. You don't call in sick. You don't miss flights. You got to be in there delivering the goods. And as Ric Flair would say, walking the aisle. Now here he goes. Rick's trying to keep him away so maybe Bruce can get a little bit of his breast back. And I know I keep accidentally saying his name, but Agent Steele and I are kind of tight. Tight enough like
Oh, what's
Tiffany.
He doing? Oh, he's back to that hip toss. Big body slam. He says, I can't beat up the champion. I'll just beat up the master of the stunner. What is he? No, he's not.
No, he's calling for the bell. Richie Rich.
That ain't
that
right.
Ridiculous. Richie Rich was hip tossing this man not 2 minutes ago, and now he's calling for the bell because he's giving a little shot back. This is unheard of. I have never seen such a thing.
I have to agree with you. You don't see that much here in IPW. Fans, it looks like by disqualification, your winner and still champion, Agent Steel.